we are in the presence of the Lord. So let us focus our hearts and minds to what He is going to reveal to us through His Word and by His Spirit. So, i-ready po natin ang ating mga sarili. Magkaroon tayo ng willingness to pay attention to the Lord our God. Those who do not believe in the Lord live their lives as if everything depended on them. Mapapansin natin yan sa mga tao na they just go ahead and do whatever they want to do. Occasionally siguro thinking about God, lalo na kung may mga trials or testings. But normally if things are going well, they would just live as if God is not important, or they do not really think much about Him. Again, unless there is a trial or merong crisis sa buhay nila. But otherwise, it's just life as normal, you know, just doing what they can to accomplish yung mga pangarap nila sa buhay, to feel good, maybe to pursue their love life, their careers, or just take care of their families, etc. Pero those who believe in Jesus, they know that they need God's grace every moment of their lives. They hunger and thirst for grace because they know that everything in their existence depends upon it. Without grace, they know they cannot survive nor thrive in this world. Pero they know now with grace, nothing is impossible with God. And grace is not just parang God's attitude or the way He relates with us, which is true. It's also about His power that is at work sa buhay natin so that His will and His purpose can be accomplished. Without grace, of course, there's nothing else that we can expect. Except kung ano lang yung kaya natin on our own. But thanks be to God, He pours out grace. Especially upon those who are humble and open and truly in need of His grace. So today we want to look at the story of a young woman. Her name is Mary. And yun yung next story that Luke tells us about in his gospel, and it is found in Luke chapter 1 starting in verse 26. So basahin po natin ito, and before we read it, of course, I want you to open your heart and allow the Holy Spirit to impress upon you a word, a phrase, a feeling, or an idea na nais niyang i-impress sa inyo. Let the Lord just, you know, bring your attention to that. And if He wants to say something to you concerning that, be open and be ready. Gamitin niyo yung comments as some kind of journal. You can write it down, yung naiisip niyo, as the Lord is impressing upon you a word, a phrase, an idea, or even an emotion. So basahin po natin itong Luke chapter 1, beginning in verse 26. In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. And she who was said to be barren is in her sixth month. For nothing is impossible with God." Verse 38, "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May it be to me as you have said." Then the angel left her. This is the word of the Lord. Father, we pray right now, Panginoon, by the grace of God, mangusap po kayo sa mga puso namin lahat. And help us, O Lord, to receive yung message mo sa amin today. We open our hearts to receive your word, to receive your love, to receive your presence, your peace, your joy. Tulungan mo kami, Panginoon, na at this time, that we would just pay attention to your loving presence and allow your spirit to just move in our hearts. So speak, O Lord, we all pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. So ang topic natin today is grace and humility. Grace, like I said, ay hindi lamang po yung attitude ng Panginoon sa atin. Sometimes people think na pag sinabing grace is yung, you know, yung kabutihan ng Panginoon o yung awa niya sa atin, which is true. Sama laman lahat yun. But we must also understand grace not just in terms of yung the way God relates to us, no? But also yung kanyang power and purpose that He wants to fulfill sa buhay natin. And in fact, this is what we find in this story concerning Mary. The Lord has a wonderful purpose, you know, para kay Mary, even though she was just an ordinary young girl. Ang sabi nga, she's a virgin. Today we want to reflect upon itong story na ito. Because there is something that we can learn from her. Si Mary bilang isang ordinaryong tao, we can all relate to her kasi karamihan naman sa atin, if not all of us, are just ordinary people. So, we want to look at how she responded to God's grace upon her life, no? As the Lord revealed, ika nga, yung will niya, yung purpose niya, and yung power niya that she's about to experience. Paano nag-respond si Mary? So, this is our topic sa devotions natin today. What should be our response to grace? Grace, of course, is God's willing gifts sa ating lahat. If we are, of course, also willing to receive. Of course, not in the same way na nangyari kay Mary because her situation is unique. No? She became the mother of Jesus, our Savior. Pero at the same time, lahat naman tayo, no, can also be recipients of grace. If we are humble and willing to receive it. Sabi sa Bible, you know, si Peter sabi niya na God rejects the proud but gives grace to the humble. So what should be our response to grace? So there are three humble responses, I believe, now we should try to exemplify. And ika nga, we can look at Mary as our example and find encouragement kung paano siya nag-respond. So, first of all, makikita natin yung element of surprise, no? So, verse 26 to 29. So, tingnan natin yan and let's understand what that means. Surprise. Sabi ganito sa verse 26, in the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee. So, yung sixth month na yun, of course, is referring to sa pregnancy ni Elizabeth. Which means na connected ito doon sa storya na that preceded, no? Yung appearance ng angel kay Zechariah and eventually yung pregnancy ni Elizabeth. And so we can see that Luke is intending to structure itong storya na to as being back-to-back. Eventually, we would see na there's going to be a comparison between these two stories. Now, in contrast, kay Zechariah, wherein God sent the angel doon sa temple, sa holy place, in a very, ika nga, sacred environment. This time, God sent the angel Gabriel, the same angel, no, to Nazareth, a town in Galilee. Now, for those of us who may not be familiar with yung topography o yung geography doon sa Middle East, yung Nazareth, especially during that time, is a parang a nowhere place. And it's not important. It's not like, kunyari sa bansa natin, sa Pilipinas, we might say, you know, Metro Manila, you know, or Cebu. Pero if we are, you know, if you mention some obscure barangay somewhere, that would be similar to Nazareth. Nazareth is not an important place. And that gives us, you know, a clue na itong birth narrative na ito would involve, you know, a place na hindi naman ganun ka-importante, hindi naman Forbes Park, you know, or Dasmariñas Village. It's just going to be happening in a place na obscure. Tapos sabi nga niyan sa verse 27, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph. So, hindi pa binabanggit kung sino yung virgin, pero sabi lang to a virgin. Now, that means a person who's not yet married, who does not have a sexual relationship experience yet, no? But at the same time, yung mga ganung klaseng babae during that time are usually younger teens. As young as 12, you know? Pataas. So, in other words, young women, they get married, and usually merong proseso yon. First, there is the intention and the payment of dowry na binibigay sa mga magulang, no? And then there's a one-year pledge wherein they are considered married na even though di pa sila nagsasama. And after that 1 year, saka pa lang sila magsasama sa isang actual na wedding, which is usually one whole week. So, itong pledge to be married means they are considered to be married, pero hindi pa sila nagsasama. That's why she's still a virgin. So, sabing ganyan, siya daw ay pledged to be married to a man named Joseph. Now, si Luke does not take much attention kay Joseph or sa side ni Joseph. Unlike si Matthew, in the Gospel of Matthew, more kay Joseph yung focus. Pero dito sa Luke, ang focus niya ay si Mary. So sabi lang niya tukol kay Joseph na he is a descendant of David. And again, inulit na naman, the virgin's name was Mary. So emphasizing muli yung kanyang kalagayan that even though she's married, hindi pa siya nagkakaroon ng sexual relationship with Joseph. And her name is just simply Mary. Now, of course, nung unang panahon, ang mga pangalan ay just by first name. Walang katulad sa atin ngayon na dalawa ang pangalan natin, yung apelido, no ba? First name sa kanyang apelido. Pero nung araw, ang mga pangalan ay Mary, no? daughter of somebody, or Joseph, son of somebody. Okay? So, sabi sa verse 28, the angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." So, that was an amazing, and sudden greeting from an angel. Sabi niya, greetings, you who are highly favored. You know, highly favored means that talagang yung grace of God, is being poured out sa buhay ni Mary. At sabi pa ng angel, "The Lord is with you." Okay? Or actually, literally, "The Lord with you." In other words, here's the presence of the Lord right now, sa mundo mo at sa buhay mo. And then in verse 29, this is what I mean by surprise. Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. No? And that response tells us a lot about Mary. In her humility, of course, she knows her situation. She knows her place. Alam niya na she's just an ordinary young woman, pledged to be married. But that's all. She lives in a place like Nazareth, a town in Galilee na wala namang significance. So, sa madaling salita, there's really nothing, that she would expect. And she knows that. Kaya nung siya ibinati ng parang, nagulat siya. And of course, makikita rin natin dito somehow yung kanyang spirituality because she was troubled at his words. Hindi yung the fact na may angel na nakikipag-usap sa kanya. No? So, she may be a woman din kahit paano, although it's just by inference, na maybe she's a woman who's also spiritual in her character, na she is not surprised at all by the way God would, move in her life. Except that itong greeting na ito was really amazing para sa kanya. She was surprised. In other words, she was not expecting na she would be treated that way. Now, the reason why, ba't ko sinasabi na yung surprise is a humble response? It's because, those who want to respond humbly before the Lord, alam nila that they don't deserve anything. They don't demand. Each and every day they are grateful to God. One of the things na makikita mo sa mga humble people is that they don't take for granted the grace of God. That's why, people who understand these things, each day and each moment of their lives, they want to draw near to God, to humbly seek God's grace. They don't parang assume it. They don't parang just, because they are such good people or they are such great people, they don't even have to ask for it. People who are humble before the Lord, alam nila yung tunay nilang situation. This is what I mean by surprise, no? Meaning to say na we don't presume upon God and we don't parang assume a stance as if parang, God will help me, ganyan naman talaga, parang ina-assume mo lang. Kaya nga siguro may mga tao na who seldom pray, who seldom seek God, because they're just assuming na, God will help me. Pero those who are humble of heart, they seek the Lord. They wait upon God. They don't presume upon grace. And if there's anything that God does sa buhay nila, they're quite surprised in the sense na parang, "Lord, I don't deserve this." I think that's what Mary is showing us. Yung kanyang response na yun, she wondered and she was troubled kasi why would the angel give her so much importance? Sino ba naman siya? I think Mary was showing us sa kanyang response that she's not the kind of person na nagpe-presume na siya ay deserving o mabuting tao. But rather, she's looking at herself and saying, I don't deserve any of this. I'm so highly favored. I'm humbled by this treatment from the Lord. So, kung i-apply natin sa buhay natin yan, every opportunity, every situation na maaaring i-offer sa atin ng Panginoon kung saan He wants to use us, you know, we want to look at it as a privilege, and you know, we're surprised that God would even use us. Siguro, the more you understand yourself, the more you know kung sino ka, the more you begin to appreciate na God's goodness and mercy sa buhay mo. Like for example, ako, when I look at my own self and my, you know, kung anong klaseng tao ako, and sometimes I wonder, Lord, wala naman po akong pwedeng ipagmalaki or anything. It's all by your grace. And I really truly appreciate that. So again, humility is, no, nakikita mo sa surprise natin when God shows us His favor, when God, in His mercy, uses us, kunyari sa ministry. You know, we are so appreciative, we're so parang grateful na God would even show us yung ganong klaseng mercy and compassion. Now, the second humble response that I see in Mary, yung kanyang desire to seek clarity, no? Yung kanyang desire to understand, how will this be working out, Lord? Hindi ko po nauunawaan. Thank you, Lord, for your grace, pero how will this work out? We see this in verse 30 to 37. Sabi nga nun sa verse 30, but the angel said to her, do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son. And you are to give him the name Jesus. Okay? He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end. So this is an amazing, parang announcement kay Mary. That she is being given this unique opportunity to become, ika nga, the vehicle through which the Son of God, the Savior of all mankind, is going to be born. No? It will be through her. So, parang wow, this is an amazing thing. This is such a gracious act of God upon her na hindi naman siya importante, you know. Kung compared kay Zechariah and Elizabeth, I mean, they are people na masasabi natin na prominent in the Israelite society. Pero si Mary, who is she? Hindi naman siya importante. She's a nobody. And yet God chose her to be the mother of Jesus. And she will give birth, no, to a son. Kaya yung response ni Mary is verse 34, you know, is, you know, something that reveals humility. Sabi niya, how will this be? Mary asked the angel, you know, since I am a virgin. So, ang kanyang inquiry is hindi katulad kay Zechariah, though. Sa Zechariah kasi sabi niya, how can I be sure? No? So, even though maraming storya in the Old Testament about barren women giving birth, diba? Like Sarah, you know, maraming well-known na babae na, like Hannah, ganon, diba yung nanay ni Samuel. Pero si Zechariah was at that point sa buhay niya na he had doubts, you know? Sabi niya, how can I be sure? Pero si Mary, ang kanyang response is, so Lord, how will this be? How will this work out? Kasi I am a virgin. In other words, unless ang ibig sabihin ng angel is that maghihintay lang si Mary until na finally mag-consummate yung marriage niya with Joseph, so eventually magkakaroon siya ng anak, no? But that's in the future, no? Pero it seems na yung angel is actually saying, in effect, na ngayon na, mangyayari na ito. So Mary's question was, paano to, Lord? And the angel answered, the Holy Spirit, you know, will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. And then sabi pa niya, even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. And she who was said to be barren is in her sixth month. And finally, sabi ng angel, for nothing is impossible with God. So now, you know, as a humble response to this wonderful announcement, Ang response ni Mary is she wanted to seek clarity, just to understand, Lord, anong part ko dito? What am I supposed to be doing in this grace that you are giving me? So when we are humble, we seek the Lord, and we seek His guidance sa atin, especially when He's opening a door of opportunity para sa atin, when He wants to use us for something na alam natin, di naman tayo deserving. You know, when the Lord is providing a platform for us or an open door to do some great work for His namesake, alam natin di tayo deserving dun. But a humble response is we seek clarity. We ask the Lord, Lord, paano po ito? How will this work out? Hindi yung, Lord, may situation akong ganito, you know. Sorry, Lord, busy ako. Lord, may trabaho ako. Lord, ganito, ganyan. Instead, we are, you know, willing to just ask God for discernment and guidance, Panginoon. Ano po ang magiging papel ko dito sa gagawin mo, Panginoon? See, people who understand grace, first of all, they show surprise kapag God gives them the opportunity to do something na alam naman nila hindi sila deserving. And then they seek clarity. Lord, how do I participate in this work? Or what do I need to do? How can I prepare? You see, people who understand grace, alam nila na when God gives them, you know, a ministry, kunyari, an opportunity to serve the Lord, hindi sila parang nag-i-excuse o nagdadahilan. Unang-una, they are quite surprised that God would even use them. Pero pangalawa, they want to know kung ano yung participation nila doon sa process. Kailangan ba nila ng training? Kailangan ba nila ng mentoring? You know, so they're willing to say, Lord, just show me kung ano po yung gagawin ko. Kung ano yung aking part dito sa nais mong gawin sa buhay ko. I just want to compare that to, you know, some people na minsan hindi nga sila attentive to the grace of God, or indeed they don't even desire God's grace. O kaya when God's grace is being offered to them, kunyari a ministry opportunity, parang they, you know, turn it down, or they say na parang, well, you know, busy kasi ako, or Pastor Bong, let me think about it, maraming sa akong ginagawa, may career ako, may love life ako. Pero yung mga humble people, when they recognize God's grace being presented to them, pag may kunyari sinabi sa kanila na, oh, kapatid, would you like to be a small group leader this semester? You know, yung mga humble people, they say, talaga, ako? I don't deserve this, you know? And of course, by God's grace, we don't deserve anything talaga. Pero anong response natin when the Lord is giving us the grace to do something in this world? Humility would say, Lord, ano po ang gusto niyong gawin ko? How will I prepare for this? Or what do I need to do, Lord, para your will and purpose can be accomplished in my life? This is a humble response, no? And so there's surprise. That shows humility. And then there's seeking of clarity, or seek clarity. And then the third humble response is surrender. And of course, we find that in verse 38, the last verse. So tingnan natin yun. Sabi ni Mary, I am the Lord's servant. Mary answered, may it be to me as you have said. You know, then the angel left her. So in other words, nung sinabi na sa kanya ng Panginoon na this is how it's going to be. Now please understand na kung ano implications no. Now Mary is pledged to be married. And she will now become pregnant even though hindi pa sila nagsasama ni Joseph. And you can imagine during that time, yung kultura nila, that would, you know, result in persecution, you know, maraming chismis na mangyayari. There will be, you know, the pressure from society or siguro yung parents ni Mary, you know, maraming complications yun. Pero anong sabi ni Mary? I am the Lord's servant, sabi niya. May it be to me as you have said. Diba? So this is what I mean by surrender. Those who are humble before the Lord, pag naging malinaw na sa kanila that God is giving them the grace to honor Him through some kind of ministry na ipagagawa sa atin, anong dapat na response natin? Surprise. We seek clarity. Lord, ano po ba ang gagawin ko? And then we surrender and say, yes, Lord, amen. If that's your will for me. If that's your will for me, Lord. So in other words, pag niyaya ka to serve the Lord bilang membro ng core team, kunyari, for example, sa RLCC, of course, you can always say, no, hindi ako ano, deserving. Of course, no one is deserving. That's why, you know, in humility, we would say, na, Lord, thank you for such an opportunity. Diba? We would be surprised, of course. And then we seek some time to discern kung ano nga ba yung ibig sabihin ng opportunity na yon. We don't just say yes, of course. We weigh yung offer ni Lord sa atin. And then eventually, we surrender everything and say, yes, Lord, if that's your will for my life, and I know na you will take care of everything else. So you see, ito yung humility na kailangan na maging response natin sa grace. So, to summarize, the right response to grace is humility. Pag tayo ay binibigyan ng Panginoon ng grace o biyaya to do something wonderful in this world for His glory, ang ating response should be humility. Hindi yung parang tina-turn down natin yung ino-offer ni Lord sa atin, na opportunity, an open door. Because we think of ourselves so highly, well, you know, parang, well, marami akong ginagawa, busy ako. Pero those who are humble, once na makita nila na it is God's grace that is being given to them, they respond humbly. Today, if you are sensing in your heart that the Lord wants you to do something, ano ang response mo sa Kanya? If you are filled with a sense of parang awe and parang, Lord, ako ba ang pinagagawa mo ng ganito? That's a good response. Pero pag sinabi mo na, Lord, marami akong gagawin, busy ako eh. That's a prideful response. So check your heart right now. If the Lord is offering you His grace, will you humbly accept it? Will you say to the Lord, Lord, even though I do not deserve it, show me the way and I will follow you. I'm so thankful to the Lord. Sa lahat ng mga nagsisay yes ngayon, lalong-lalo na in the context of RLCC. Itong semester na parating where we need to take care of a lot of people kasi maraming tao ang naliligaw, nanlalamig, nawawala sa Panginoon. So I'm thankful to God for every humble servant na nagsisay yes to be part of the core teams, to be part of the leadership team na who would shepherd God's people. No, I'm just ano lang, parang so filled with thanksgiving in my heart for people like that. Unfortunately, marami mga tao also who do not consider it as God's grace na binibigyan sila ng open door to serve God. And if you know somebody na ganoon, na maybe parang inuuna pa niya yung mga priorities niya sa buhay, you know, yung passion niya is not the great commission of God, maybe you can encourage that person and say, you know, it is God's grace that we can serve Him. Which is true naman, di ba? It is God's grace that we can serve the Lord in any capacity. So like Mary, dalangin ko na all of us would respond in humility to the grace of God in offer sa atin. Now I'm just referring kanina to, you know, being part of the leadership of a small group, but it can be anything else. Maybe God is giving you a platform to share the Word of God with your friends. Pero nagdadahilan ka na busy ka. Maybe you should check your attitude. The fact that God is giving you the grace to do that is really something na talagang dapat ma-appreciate mo. You should respond humbly to that and say, yes, Lord, according to your will, I will do what you want me to do. It could be somewhere else, di ba? It could be in the church to serve in some kind of ministry. O saan man lugar that God wants to use you. May your response be humility. May our response be humility. Let us all pray. Father, Patawarin mo kami, Panginoon, if sometimes we do not recognize the grace of God sa buhay namin, and we do not respond in humility. Lord, nawa maging katulad kami ni Mary, who was really quite surprised that she was being given such an honor. And yet at the same time, she sought clarity and discernment kung ano ba magiging participation niya. And when it became clear to her kung ano yung gagawin niya, she simply said yes. So Lord, nawa maging ganun po kami. And may we also encourage others to respond in the same way. Maraming salamat po, Panginoon, for your word for us, for your message. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.